I think that Chuck Berry is the most unheralded figure of the rock and roll genre.
His stuff was the shit, and it started everything.
In 1977, when Voyager 1 was sent out to space, the one piece of popular culture that they put on that was Johnny B. Goode.
His whole message is in every song we hear. It's become part of the culture.
You don't see covers of Heartbreak Hotel and Hound Dog, but you get an inordinate number of Chuck Berry covers.
Like I said, every time I'd go to do an album, even now I'm doing an album, I listen to a dozen Berries every night.
Quick-witted lyricism Chuck Berry had is part of what is hip-hop.
Chuck Berry created rock and roll. I mean, he made rock and roll.
Everybody's mind, and he's not getting only black people, he's getting everybody across the masses.
I think he's a pioneer in terms of sort of a deadpan delivery, straight down the middle delivery, that most rock artists do.
Chuck Berry was actually the first person inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame. You know, thanks to someone like Chuck Berry, the guitar really became the central instrument in rock and roll.
Once electronic rock hit, Chuck Berry was right there, and his now.
What can anyone say about Chuck Berry? He's the greatest songwriter, American songwriter ever.
Anything you hear on that jukebox over there, it's rock and roll, it's got some Chuck Berry in it, because it has to. He essentially invented it.
The real achievement to me are those that follow, and what they then do as a result of what the people that were the first ones there did.
I've always thought Chuck was the king of rock and roll.